You're watching Day or Night X, X is for Exotics. And this is Spock. He is my queen bee male, one of my most active male BPs in my collection. If you're a beginner, this is a three banger. It's a spider, a pastel, and a lesser. Those are three genes that I like in any snake. I'm a spider nut, I'm a pastel nut, and I definitely love anything lesser, Mojave, Mystic, etc. This guy is one of the more laid-back BPs in my collection, except when you get him outside, and like I said before in most of my vids concerning my males, BPs in particular, they tend to want to roam. They're very hard to film, and the way I film, I don't like just standing underneath the camera and kind of just holding the snake into place, and my hands are always in view, kind of just keeping the snake in place. I like the animal to be loose and free, and that takes some time filming. As you can see, he has no problem being handled at all. He's actually, he pretty much likes to be handled, but put him on a flat surface and he's gonna take off every time. He's not a ball python that does ball python characteristics of just, you know, getting up in a ball and staying in place. He is an explorer. He's a very curious little guy. He likes to look around. Now this is a full grown male, and he's not a very huge male. He's not even close to being as huge as my vanilla male. This guy here is just very slender, and he has a really nice build to him. He's actually full right now, and he still is keeping that very slender look to him. He never really bulks up extremely fat, just like my pastel genetic stripe. But unlike my vanilla, you feed him and he just keeps fattening up and fattening up and fattening up. It's just genetics with these animals, just like human beings. Every human being is different genetic wise, so he's just not a very, very huge male, which a lot of my males ironically turn out to be that way. I've never really landed outside of my vanilla just a big fat male, you know. So I mean, most of them are very athletic looking, leaned muscle, you know, just very lean and athletic looking. This guy here, I have to film him if I'm gonna go outside. I have to wait until what they say in the movie industry's magic hour. That's when the sun's about to set, and this footage was taken about a couple hours before the sun was gonna set. And he looks still under sunlight. He doesn't have the same coloration he does under artificial light, which in my opinion, he actually looks better under artificial light than he does in sunlight, because the sunlight reflects all those colors, and he actually appears to be a lot more yellow when I film him outside than he actually is. If I was to take him inside, he's actually more white. All the really yellow sections that you see on him fading off of his sides going down to the bottom of him, to his belly, that's actually pure white. There is no yellow on him at all. It's just as white as can be. But outside, he just comes off looking like a very yellow looking snake, and he's not very heavily contrasted with, like, you know, the really dark colors on him to kind of break that up. As you can see, all the colors kind of fade together. The darkest of his colors are on his head with that beautiful pattern, but all the rest of it is just a very medium like to light brown. As you can see the patterns on them, they're not very dark at all. And the only reason why they appear as dark as they do is because he is so light in tone, with his yellows on his back and the blushing on his sides going on to the white of his belly. He is a beautiful snake, but filming him outside, like I said, is very hard sometimes because the sun tends to want to blow him out, and you know, he comes off looking so yellow that it doesn't actually look very good. But today I caught it at a good time, and I'm glad I did, because he actually looks pretty good. He just shed out, and perfect time to share them.